joined us at the National Museum of Computing at Bletchley Park, and we're in the home or the personal computer section. And here's one of the most popular personal computers found in schools, the BBC Micro.
Ooh.
It had a programming language called BASIC, upon which you could do 10, print Simon is gay, 20, go to 10. We're at Bletchley Park in the National Museum of Computing still, and this here is the TR-48. It's several on from the TR-7, which was a car. And you can work out complicated arithmetic problems, like this one here.
Then we know what the answer is, don't we?
Also, it's quite a springy computer.
Springiness. And there's the answer.
Hi, we're at Bletchley Park at the National Museum of Computing, still, and here is a big mother.
Wow, look at the size of that, it's as big as a house.
It's a digital PDP 11.
I thought this room was the analog computer's room.
I didn't know they went up to 11.
Very funny.
Hi, we're at the British National Museum of Computing or something at Bletchley Park, and we're in the mainframe room. It's very main. Look at this. How main is that?
I think it looks like a branch of Curry's.
Right.
Which one? I want to go.
And you've got washing machines and ovens there and fridge freezers up there.
It does look a bit like Venice, doesn't it?
After this we're going to Colossus, but this is the main thing.
Okay, will you show us a particular machine that's your favourite, Simon?
Let's go. Here's the spaghetti machine. Made by Kodak. I really want a monitor like that at home. We're at the British Museum of National Museum of British Computers, and we have here an RM Nimbus made by Research Machines. This is the first computer that Nick ever used way back in the 1920s.
When I was Nick girl.
We're now trying to use it, but we don't know how. As you can see, I keep saying back.
Bad boy!
Hi, we're at a Xerox 860. Yes, I remember something. And it was the Rolls Royce of word processing machines. And even though it was in 1986, it came with something similar to a trackpad, but it's called a CAT. capacitance activated template or something, and it had a spell checker.
Wow. Presumably that's the tracker thing, is it?
That's it, yeah. But it's a cat as opposed to a mouse.
So what could it spell?
It could
onomatopoeia?
It could check your spells. You did the spelling.
Oh, very good.
Yeah, so there we go.
Say goodbye.
Hi, we're at the British National International Museum of Nerd Computing, and we're in the personal computer section. And over my shoulder, that one there, you can see some personal computers.
Isn't that Delamitri sound?
There's some personal computers.
Yes, here's, well no, that's not very personal, but the ZX Spectrum over there is quite personal.
Oh, look. It's personal to me, that's years of childhood. Yeah.
That's from 1983. We're in a hands-on section of the personal computers we all knew and loved as children, including the ZX81, the ZX Spectrum, some Apple Macs I don't really know a lot about, and a Commodore something.
And what did you put your hands on? What did you put your hands on, Simon?
I put my hands on my hips and I don't know, what did I put my hands on?
Don't worry, in the hands-on section, I thought you would. I'm going to move away from you now. Bye.
Bye. We're at the British International Museum of Childhood.
Hence all the screaming children running around.
And we are in a viewing gallery for Colossus.
And where is it?
It's there.
Wow.
There's some people in there.
And what
How
do they do?
Get in there? It's just solid glass.
Wow. Simon. Can you tell me the difference in a code and a cipher?
Well, some people think there isn't much of a difference, and I don't care, but evidently I do care because I do know the difference. A code is to replace something with another thing so as to confuse people who don't know what you're replacing. A cipher is where you actually change one character for another character.
And how many combinations or letters in the English alphabet are there?
26 to the factor of 20. Yeah, so 26 times 25 times 24 times 23 and so on. You can see the end. It's quite a big number.
I will never ever suggest that you have a bad memory ever again.
Thanks very much.
But I'll reserve proper judgment until I've been all the way around. Someone's put some binary on that thing over there.
Oh, what, I'm here? Oh. And what that means in English. Simon, what are you doing? You're out of control.